You see, she's beautiful.
How come you're not in school?
I'm a model.
Cool.
Do you want to be in a video for my band?
See, if you're in a band, sing me a song.
Take on me.
Everybody, welcome to What the Flick. I'm Matt Atchity, that's Alonzo Duraldi, and that's Christy Lemire. They are going to talk about Sing Street because I couldn't be bothered to see it.
Right, although you like music.
Yeah, sure.
Like
sure,
the
we
80s.
All do.
We are all children of the 80s. I will not sing
music
this
whole
review. This music is pretty great, though. So this is another film from John Carney, who did Once and Did Begin Again. It's kind of in the same vein of exploring music as a means of expression and connection and, like, you know, your angst and whatever. It takes place in the mid-80s in Dublin. It's sort of semi-autobiographical for John Carney in that regard. It's about this one boy, 14, 15-year-old boy, whose family's in financial hardship, as so many were at this point in time. He's forced to go from this nice private school to this really, really rough Catholic school. And there he forms a band because he loves music, but mostly to get the girl who lives across the street who he's got a crush on. Take a look.
We need to form a band. Connor's going to band together.
Oh, good Jesus.
You'd play every instrument known to mankind.
Probably.
Show him.
It's all about the girl, isn't it?
What's this?
Homework.
I have school in the morning.
This is school. Rock and roll is a risk. You risk being ridiculed.
Jesus, what are you all wearing?
Yeah, we're just working that out.
That's great fun.
Yeah, it's really fun.
Have you kissed her yet?
She's got a boyfriend. Pulled off in his car, music blaring.
What was he listening to?
Genesis.
No woman can truly love a man who listens to Phil Collins.
This is totally charming.
I love this guy's movies. Like, yeah. Even when they aren't, even when you can occasionally sort of know why they're not working all the time, like both this one and Begin Again, I can see some of the seams. But I don't care. I don't care. I have such a great time. And they are funny and they're moving. And the way, yeah, you're right, the way they use music as this sort of form of personal expression, and not even your own music, but just somebody else's music. Mm-hmm. You know, watching the lead character of this movie sort of try on, like, you know, different the Duran Duran right. look, and then the Cure look, and then those hats. You know, like all the all the kind of 80s, you know, new wave sort of, you know, fashion statements and stuff as he's trying to figure out who he is.
Right.
It's adorable.
But what's so great about that is it's this amazing soundtrack. If you are a child of the 80s, like we are, it's like Duran Duran, the Cure. There's a town called Malice is in it at one point. A Spandau Ballet song, but it's not just, oh, here's a great song from Duran Duran, oh, here's a great song from whoever. Like, it's totally germane to this kid's transformation.
There's a context to when it exists and why and what it means to these people.
Yeah, and how his band finds its sound.
Yeah.
Because at first they're doing covers, and so I gotta say really fast, the kid who stars in it, Ferdia Walsh-Peelo, excellent.
Yeah.
Looks like a young Paul McCartney, kind of.
Yeah,
he's got the hair.
Yeah, yeah.
But he and his older brother, played by Jack Rayner, who's also excellent, had these conversations about, it can't just be a cover band. Anybody in any pub can have a cover band.
Yeah.
And you gotta find your own art.
And it was like every town has a cover band, and every cover band has a guy who wonders what would have happened if he'd tried his own music.
Right, yeah. So he learned, this kid learns to push himself and challenge himself and use his own experiences to write lyrics. And there's a great Genesis joke in this.
Yeah.
But this is why the music is so germane to this story, and not just as a, oh yeah, I love
get
that
the soundtrack.
Song. Oh yeah, I love the Duran Duran Rio video. It mattered. So I love this. And John Carney does borrow from himself yet again quite a bit. You know, there's a lot in Begin Again that was very similar to Once.
Mm.
There are individual scenes and images and moments that remind me of both of those films.
Sure.
There's a scene where the band that he forms with his nerdy friends at school is working through one of their new songs, and the camera kind of pans around the room, and eventually each person shows up in the room with his instrument, which reminded me of that scene in Begin Again, where Mark Ruffalo is sitting at the bar and he's drunk, but he's envisioning the pieces of music coming in. And then there's also a scene where the girl, who's her name, Lucy Boynton, the cute girl across the street, the cute damaged girl across the street that he likes, she's walking around listening to a song on her headphones, kind of like in Once. Yeah. But, so there are a lot of things that are definitely borrowed, and on the whole, this reminds me a lot of The Commitments, too.
Oh, totally. Yeah.
It's unavoidable, but it's its own thing.
This guy, I mean, Carney just makes these really sweet films, and, you know, they're not... He's so not interested in realism, you know. He is such a romantic, and he's so in love with the idea of people sort of discovering their best selves through music or pushing themselves to places they thought they'd be afraid to go or whatever. And you know, there's something just wonderfully old-fashioned about his filmmaking, and I mean that in a good way.
Yeah. It's guileless.
Yeah, totally. So if you didn't like Once or Begin Again, and you think this guy's corny, this is not going to be the movie to win you over. But if you are down with what he is selling, you will want another helping out.
Yeah, there's a scene. Speaking of not realism, there's a whole fantasy sequence that takes place during a video shoot that I wanted to cry. It was so beautiful.
It was gorgeous.
So anyway, if you like this kind of movie, you'll dig it. Great. Yeah. And also, besides just the great 80s songs, the original songs in it are pretty darn catchy.
Yes, they are. One of which was co-written by Glenn Hansard from
Once. There you go. Yeah. There you go. So what's your number then?
I give it 8.5.
I'm saying 8.7, so our average is a very easy 8.6. And where is it?
And it's in the mid-90s on the tomato meter right now.
Go see it.
Yeah, it's really
great week.
All right, I will.
Yeah. Please go see it.
I will.
Matt will, you have to too. Bye.